What is up, guys? Fatal82 coming at you with a raid cam from the US Rastopia. No, I'm sorry, it's not the US Rastopia server. Actually, the European Rastopia server, the UK EU Rastopia server. It's been long requested for me to do a video over there, so I thought I would honor that and do a raid cam over there. And getting ready into it, guys, we see a team moving out of six men. So this would be between a fire team and a squad if we're thinking about military formations. And they are moving with a destination in mind. I wasn't initially sure if this was going to be a raid cam, but it certainly is. And that's a good thing because you guys have been wanting to see that. But as they move out, take note of the path that they took. They had to swim across a deep channel there, which made them very prone to incoming fire. Thankfully, they didn't meet up with anyone, but while they're swimming in that deep water, they can't manipulate their weapons, and they're very limited in terms of their defenses and also their offenses. Unlike the water here, this water is very shallow, and this basically should just be a dry area. The water here is so shallow that they can just run across it, still fire, and function very much the same way. The characters will get wet, they could potentially get cold at night, but this type of water is really not going to be something that's very protective for that base that's across here. And as you can see that the fire team moves in here, they are not heading towards that base, so they don't own that big base, but they're heading towards this mean, nasty looking little base here, which is a forward operating base or a raid base. This one is one though that looks like it has spikes to it, sort of has thorns to it, and it's absolutely gnarly looking. And when you compare it to the big base, it is sort of a David and Goliath scenario here with the raid base, you know, being sort of the underdog, but it looks just fucking mean when you look at that raid base, the way that the high exterior walls are positioned there, around it, the high exterior gateway. You don't typically see that in the forward operating bases. And then the base itself has the loot rooms, the spawn points, and also places to fire from, which are those slanted roof tiles. As you can see, they're doing a hell of a job of keeping the defenders at bay. They poke their heads out of their hatchways, and they're immediately ducking for cover. One thing about the roof of that big base is they don't have a lot of defenses on that roof, so if they want to shoot, they're going to need to throw down some barricades. The people inside the base have names that look like viruses you would get from a strange porn site, so I'm not sure what that's all about, guys. If anyone has any backstory on that, go ahead and throw it in the comments. Curious of what those names are all about. They did look kind of strange, but I'm sure there's some type of meaning to that. So getting back into the raid cam, the base was able to be accessed through a crack in the spacing rather in the high exterior stone walls. This likely was something the raiders knew about because they went to it in no time at all, and they likely scouted this area before and figured out that this was going to be their entry point. It's a little bit of a tight spot to get into, but they appeared to be able to get at least three members in there with rocket launchers, so they're starting to open up pathways into that base. Rocket launchers are really the raiding tools that we see used in Rust right now. It's very rare actually to see C4 to use, guys, and I kind of miss that sound of it when that beeping sound is very nice to hear. But we rockets are the tool of the day for raiding, and you can see that they're opening up the base nicely here. This is a base that's honeycombed, but it's honeycombed a little bit differently in that it's not all the same base, and it's more separate structures. I don't want to give away too many secrets, and that's not the purpose here. We only show in the raid cam basically what you could see if someone was recording the raid themselves. So it's not anything you wouldn't be able to see if somebody else wasn't recording. But the base did have some secrets to it. I wasn't sure how well it would hold up to a raid, but you guys will see in a moment how well it holds up. So the raiders are doing some great progress. They're using speed and aggression, getting up into the base very quickly, which is exactly what they want to do. When rockets are going off, it's very hard to figure out what's going on. And as you can see, a wall just came down in the inner core of the base here. So the defenders and the raiders are now toe-to-toe with small arms here. There's shotguns going on. They have some submachine guns and some AKs. For all purposes, guys, this is mid-game Rust if you're wondering where it is in the progression of things. So even though it's a massive base and they do have some good gear, this is still considered mid-game Rust. This was a couple days into the wipe cycle. So you can see that they're using, the defenders rather, are using the hatches very wisely here. They're opening up doors and hatches, closing them, firing, and that's a very effective method. They were able to just take out a couple raiders there with a rocket. So it's something that they're really using to their advantage, and I'm not sure that the inner part of the base was necessarily designed for those defensive purposes, but they're using that those options very wisely. Taking a break in the action here, they didn't take that for granted. They didn't hide in their base. They jumped back down and they threw up a high exterior stone wall to patch up, to plug up that hole that was blown in by the rockets. That's something that's really important to do in raids. We've talked a lot about it before, guys. I'm going to say it again, not to sound like a broken record, but just to really emphasize that raiding is a resource game. You can see that emphasized in the footage right now. The raiders are coming back less well geared. They're coming back naked. They have ragtag armor on at this point, so it's mismatched. It's not as high-end as it was before, and again, that's indicative of that mid-game rust. They don't have as many supplies, but it's also just something that would happen in any raid. Even end-game raids, there's always a point where the raiders are going to lose so many resources that they're not going to be able to continue with the raid because they just won't have the ability to. So if you can fend off the first wave or two of raiders, typically you're going to out-resource them in most situations. So the raiders here, though, are not out-resourced, at least yet at this point in time. They're making another attempt to get back into that base. They're pulling those rockets back out. So they do have a lot of rockets, and they're opening that base back up. So all the work that the defenders did to plug it back up, they're going right back into it. As you can see, though, this base is, again, a tricky one with the way that it is set up. It is not the traditional honeycombing that we see, and again, I don't want to give away too many secrets, but you guys can probably deconstruct some stuff by just looking at it. We'll take a better look at it in the rust cribs that'll be coming up later on this week or early next week. So the doors here, guys, are spaced in a way where when the rockets will hit one door, they won't have blast damage onto the other one, so it's a very resource intensive base to raid. That inner courtyard of the base, or not courtyard, but inner circle where the loot rooms are, has been again breached. The raiders are now up in there, but shit's gotten primitive. So you can see that the raiders, and in some cases the defenders, are coming back with, you know, hatchets, rocks, salvaged, you know, axes. So it's very, very primitive at this point in time, and oftentimes in mid-game rust you'll see it go back to early game, you know, kind of quick, because players don't have a lot of resources to keep up with it. The defenders are keeping up with it, though, quite well, because they haven't lost a heck of a lot, it appears. We can't really estimate what each side's winning or losing here, but or gaining or losing, I guess would be a better word. But we can say definitely that there's rockets on the bodies of the raiders. That's always the case with a raid, so the defenders are picking up a lot of loot. They're actually getting quite a payday here. Even though they're getting their base hollowed out a bit and getting some holes punched into it, they might be getting more out of the raid than they're losing from the resources they need to patch it up. Think about it that way too, guys, when you think about Rust. If you're not a Rust player, you might not, you know, think about it that way, but oftentimes there is you know, sort of a trade-off. You might get your base badly damaged, you might have to do a lot of work to repair it, but you might have gained a lot of rockets, armor, weapons, ammo off of raiders, so it's a very risky thing. And that's also the risk of raiding in Rust, because there's not a way to transport your material other than with manpower, so you have to run everything over here. To be able to build that raid base, I wasn't online to see it built, but that probably had to, you know, be well coordinated to get that to come up. I'm not exactly sure what time this raid occurred on the UK. Due to time zones, I'm not sure, you know, what that would have been. But there were about 260 people on the server, so it was fairly well populated. So I'm assuming it wasn't too off-center for that server. Getting into it, though, guys, the base is one that is needs to be patched up, but there's also some holes in it, some gaps in it that are inherent to the design of the base. Those can't be patched up without throwing maybe a high exterior stone wall just on the outside of it. But notice how they're using the holes in the base when they go in here as a choke point, a bit of a bottleneck. Both the defenders and the raiders are using this as a way to both see into the base and also fire into the base. And it's kind of 50-50 on both sides as to, you know, how that's being used. You can just see the bodies piling up around here. If you take note throughout the video, the bodies just pile on top of one another, and this is really a house of carnage, a house of death. It's almost, in a sense, it feels like a high-end trap house in some ways, because it's a very difficult one to raid in many ways, and the raiders did, you know, really everything right. They pushed into it quickly, but they get caught up in, you know, really just the trap of the design of the base, I guess. And as you can see, they didn't get too far, or haven't yet made it too far into the base. So love seeing some shotgun action here, guys. We don't see them used often enough, but it's so rewarding, and they're taking down some of those raiders. They're going down nicely as we pan back out here. Just take a note again that the main base and that fire base, that forward operating base, are still trading fire, so they're still going toe-to-toe. Again, that David Goliath scenario there with the small base versus the big one. But that raid base is no joke. These defenders, if they want to have peace of mind around their base, they're going to have to take out that raid base, no doubt. They can't let it sit, so it's going to be after something. It's going to be something they're going to have to push towards, whether it's now or later. They're going to have to figure out how to neutralize that. The raiders will eventually give up. If they lose enough resources, they'll have to go home. If they can't fight, there's not much that can be done, but they'll always have access to that, so the defenders need to either wipe it out completely or take control over it. You can see here, guys, that the defenders are moving out. The defenders are in the Beach Hills hoodies here. They're using the great tactics. They're using great tactics to their advantage. They're hiding behind the high exterior stone walls. They're moving slowly. They're trying to figure out the best approach towards that forward operating base. They're not focusing too much on patching up their base at this point in time. I think they know they have the raiders on the run here, and they're trying to both gain access to the supplies that the raiders have before they run them back out and swim them away. And they're also trying to take that base while they have some advantages. If you'll notice, the raiders actually left their high exterior stone gateway open, so that would give the perhaps the defenders an advantage if they were to go into the base that way. But you can see again here, they're using great tactics, and they're strafing back and forth and calling out shots. And then the raiders are also using great tactics, using that forward operating base for exactly the purposes that it was built for. Not only to house supplies, but also to oppress the enemy, which in this case are these defenders. We're back at that hole in the wall, guys, that fucking glory hole. I'm going to call it a glory hole because it is glorious for the defenders. So at this point in the raid, I think it's safe to say the tides have turned. The defenders now have the upper hand. They remained calm, cool, collected. They took the defensive points at the top of their base. They had a defensive point right outside one of the entranceways, which was a little bit above the main entrance, where they could shoot over the high exterior stone walls down into the place where the raiders were coming in. What they're doing here, though, is not really cool or kosher, I don't think, in Rust. Note, though, the guy that just got capped in the head, he was looking the wrong way. If he had been focusing the other way, he may have been able to do some more damage. He was a defender who, or raider rather, who got blasted when he was looking at the door going outside rather than inside. But this scene here, guys, I love because it is looks like mazes of rats, or rats in a maze rather, kind of navigating their way through the maze. And Rust is really a big social experiment. I think that's really kind of the core of it, beyond the survival aspects. But getting back to what the defenders here were doing, that's really ballsy but also quite stupid, I guess I would say, was they're leaving their doors open. You can see all the red lights on there, but those doors are wide open. So if that main door gets breached, if the raiders have a few more rockets, they can get through that. All those doors that are open, if they go anywhere of importance, which hopefully they don't, you know, they're going to be able to just glide right down there. So always close your doors, guys. Don't ever take that for granted. That's how you get steamrolled over in Rust. And I know that from experience. We all, you know, have had those experiences in Rust, you know. Don't be lazy, guys. Take the time to close your freaking door. It's not a big deal to click it, especially when you're in the middle of a raid. Beautiful shots here, guys. Beautiful, beautiful shots with the muzzle flashes lighting up the night sky, and then seeing some of those rounds light up the night sky, some of the tracers. Looks beautiful, and some torches are going off here. Look, though, note how the defenders moved out in formation there. I love how they rush out of the base. It's like they all woke up, right? It was like there were three dudes defending the base, and all of a sudden, there's like eight guys who roll out. So probably what that is it was an off time on the server at this point, because the raid was lasting over an hour, so you know, so people probably went to bed or were waking up and getting calls from their friends, messages, and they got on, so the raid became a bit more active. So in terms of what's left in that raid base or forward operating base, who knows? Only the raiders and the defenders are really going to know here in terms of what was gained or lost from it. The raiders may have had a chance to sneak some of the supplies back out of there. They also probably lost a lot of it when they were inside the main base that they were raiding over there. When the bodies were falling, there were probably lots of supplies on them. So it's hard to really say, but this base needed to be taken control of because it couldn't exist here. It couldn't coexist with the base defenders because it was just you know, not something that was meant to be in that landscape, and it was going to be a point of oppression if it were to stay there. So, as you can see now, the defenders are very aggressive. They are now the raiders, and the defenders are now the, you know, people who were raiding previously. They are defending their raid or forward operating base as the defenders, or raiders rather, build up into it, and they are able to manipulate the shutters and the doors without the locks because they can build right up there. A random naked from down the beach was trying to shoot out the quick structures that were allowing the defenders to go up and defend their base and get rid of the raiders. I'm not sure he really realized what he was doing there, because probably those raiders would have been coming for him next. But it's good all the same, and always fun to see people mixing it up and getting involved who aren't necessarily part of the raid. So in here, this is footage of the raiders or the defenders hollowing into that raid base to see what's left in supplies and also to root out the leftover raiders. I think we just saw a case of friendly fire there. If not, guys, go ahead and let me know in the comments, but I'm pretty sure that was friendly fire, and that was really cool to see. Rust is an unforgiving game, and I love it for that. So down here on the beach, some nakeds have gotten into a melee, and I'm not sure if these were perhaps the raiders coming back, if they had sleeping bags, or if it was just some random nakeds. I didn't catch the names, but it was really cool to see that chaos going on. And it's always good to scavenge big raids, so if you're a solo player or a smaller player, or any player for that matter, you can run up to a raid and probably walk away with some stuff in the middle of all this chaos. So guys, as always, really hope you enjoyed this raid cam. I know you like them. I like making them when I can spectate and find a good raid. Alright guys, as we go ahead and wind this down, just wanted to say once again, thanks for everyone who likes and supports these videos with their views and likes. Much appreciated. Fade away D2. Peace.